Hey Jewel fans, it's Ronnie from the Jewel Writers Archive. A little over 3 years ago, I had the amazing experience of meeting Kerry Butler just a few days after I had actually gone to Avalon, which is the Catalina Island in Southern California, for my birthday. For those of you who might not know, Kerry Butler, who is a renowned Broadway actress, was in her very early stages of her career when she voiced Princess Gwenevere. These video clips, taken from the Revenge of the Darkstone and Full Circle 1995 voice recording sessions, show a very young Kerry Butler, surrounded by her fellow voice actors, John Beach as Drake, who we have to thank for this recording, Laura Dean as the beloved Tamara, Deborah Allison as the adventurous Fallon, Corrine Orr as the fabulous Lady Kale, and the incomparable Bob Caliban as Merlin. While I was on the island, I saw that Kerry was posting about her performance in an upcoming show called Broadway Arts, and it was going to be right in Anaheim, which is very close to where I worked at the time. I purchased the tickets and very excitedly started to communicate with Kerry Butler. I told her that I was going to be attending the event and that if she would be available for a conversation afterwards, I would love to meet with her and do a quick interview. She was very gracious and said that she would be willing to do so. And so we attended the event. Here are some recordings of Kerry Butler during the performance.
Story. I also have a different angle on why the arts are important. But the arts touches all of us, and it's important for, it helps you in every single aspect of whatever you do in life. So that's like my little story on the arts.
After the show, I eagerly waited for Kerry to emerge from backstage. Once she did, a very excited me introduced myself to her, and we began to have our conversation. When asked about Princess Gwenevere, she did remember some things. However, as to be expected, some memories have faded with time. Here is the original recording from that night. Now, it is recorded, unfortunately, in vertical video syndrome. But we'll overlook that, as it was still an amazing experience.
Hi everyone, I'm here with Kerry Butler, the voice of Princess Gwenevere from Princess Gwenevere and the Jewel Writers.
Hello!
So Kerry, just a couple of quick questions for you. First of all, again, wonderful performance. Thank you so much for visiting us here today in Anaheim. We're just wondering though, obviously we've been fans of the show Princess Gwenevere for a long time. What kind of brought you to the Jewel Writers initially?
I just auditioned for it.
You just auditioned
yeah,
for it?
Yeah.
Okay. Was that your first role doing voiceover at work?
No. I did another voiceover. I feel like that was big in me for animation. Like, you know, I played a few different characters on that show and it was recurring, so it was really fun. You know, you got to know the other actors and it was fun. Well, you saw the video, like how we all recorded in the same...
Right, the behind the scenes video.
Yeah, it was fun.
That's awesome to see, just the camaraderie.
Yeah.
Now, do you still have contact with anyone else nowadays?
Not really.
No?
No. I feel like maybe I would see one of them on a voiceover version, but not really around that.
Gotcha. Well, obviously, you do love animation. You love Disneyland, right? You love Disney. Do you have a favorite Disney character?
Ariel?
That's my favorite, too. Oh, my gosh. That's awesome. So is The Little Mermaid your favorite movie as well?
Yes.
Awesome. Do you have a favorite attraction?
My favorite attraction is PhilharMagic.
PhilharMagic.
Because you go under the sea with Ariel.
There you go. It is pretty awesome, isn't it? With regards to Gwen, is that just your natural voice?
I feel like I made it a little bit, I played two characters. So one of them I made deeper, and it is my voice, but I made it a little bit slightly, like, altered, more like a Disney princess kind of voice, like a, like the power of the sunstone, right? That's, isn't that things I say?
Awesome.
Yeah.
Perfect. Do you have a favorite memory regarding the production of the show?
No, I just remember I loved doing it.
I think that's awesome. And if people want to find more work, and I'm sorry they didn't bring my CD, actually, in the middle of moving and so all my CDs are packed up, but do you have other work that people can find you?
What do you mean?
With regards to current projects, like, do you have, like, a website? I mean, I know your social media.
Yeah, that's right. I have a website, but I feel like it's not up to date. But, yeah, I'm Kerry Butler, NYC at Twitter. So I usually post when I'm doing concerts on there. And I have a Facebook fan page. And I should put my website back up. So that's Kerry Butler at net.com. So, yeah.
Perfect. And then right now with Broadway, what exactly are you working on right now? I know that you just finished up Disaster, wasn't it?
Oh, yes, I just finished Disaster. I'm doing a lot of workshops and hoping, you know, one of them sticks. I just did Bat Boy, and I originally played Shelley, the teenage daughter in Bat Boy, and now they want to bring it back to Broadway, and or on Broadway for the first time, and they want me to play the mom. So we'll see what happens.
Very cool. Awesome. Yeah. Thank you so much. We can cut the film. Thank you.
You can imagine I was quite nervous. After all, I was meeting the voice actress who brought to life one of my all-time favorite characters. After our very brief interview, I asked Kerry if she would sign a couple of autographs for me. I had already printed out some pictures of Gwenevere in two different versions for her to sign. Kerry was so gracious in doing all this for me. I was very appreciative. And in the end, we had to get a snapshot of the two of us together. I like to think that by having this interview with Kerry, it kind of put a reminder in her head of the Jewel Writers' work that she had done. Because in later interviews, she has brought up Princess Gwenevere once again, which is fun to hear her talk about. Here's an excerpt from her Breaking Broadway podcast. The veteran Broadway actress teaches how to break into the business of being a Broadway performer. In episode 5, It's Not Over Till It's Voiceover, Kerry and guest Annie Meisels talk about doing voice work, including cartoons. And best of all, Kerry talks briefly about Princess Gwenevere herself, even if she doesn't quite land by the magic of the Sunstone, right? We'll forgive her. It has been 25 years, after all.
Yeah, I know. That is fun. And then another way to use your skills is doing cartoons. Have you done cartoons?
Have I done cartoons? I did one kind of interstitial. Is that what they call interstitial thing? But
I'm surprised you haven't done more cartoons. You have great
cartoons.
I
would love to do cartoons. I don't audition for that.
You don't audition for them?
Mm-mm, do you?
I do. I auditioned for a lot of cartoons.
Recently, I have in the past like 3 months, but before that, I hadn't.
I love doing cartoons.
Really?
I
would love
so
to do them.
So much fun.
And I don't know why. I assume they cast more out of LA, but that's.
They do cast a lot in LA, but.
That's great. Did you do?
I did this one called Princess Gwenevere and the Jewel Riders. I was Princess Gwenevere. This is Princess Gwenevere by the power of the Jewel Stone. I said something like that.
Oh.
Not quite right, Kerry. Let's try that one more time. Voice over. Take two.
By the power of the gemstone. I don't know whether I said something like that, but I know I said something like that.
One more time, Kerry. Voice over. Take three.
By the magic of the Sunstone, you're tuned into the Jewel Riders Archive.
Perfect.
That's fun.
Yeah, it was really, really fun.
Oh my God.
It's a great listen, and we can't wait to hear more episodes from Kerry. You can find more at her podcast, which is hosted on Podbean, the same place you can find the Jewel Riders Archive podcast. Well, thanks so much for walking down memory lane with me, going back 3 years to our interview and beyond. Looking at some fun, Kerry memories that not only tell more about the story of Jewel Riders, but also give us a better understanding of who this amazing person is. And as we prepare to celebrate 25 magical years of Princess Gwenevere and the Jewel Riders, I hope that you'll join me in saying our sign-off. Friends together, friends forever. Bye, everyone.
By the magic of the Sunstone, you're tuned into the Jewel Riders Archive.
I'm Minerva, Fallon's mother, and I don't approve of this hike!